Amit. I've been in the operations supply chain industry for over 12 years, spanning multiple continents. I started off my career as an operations manager slash production manager in the automotive industry for Tata Hitachi, which is a giant in the Asian market. And following my move to Vancouver 10 years ago, I've been working with pump manufacturing companies in background. I've worked in the supply chain for the medical marijuana industry. Notably, I've worked for Amazon last 4 years, and most recently as director of supply chain with Mountain Equipment Co-op, MEC. The way I look at it is this is a culmination of the recent developments in the people, process, and system side of supply chain. So supply chain is such an integral aspect of business. It connects all other departments in the business, from finance all the way to customer service. So it's very imperative to understand what is the latest happening out there, be it in the sector of people management like workforce scheduling, be it in technology management like ERP or distributed order management, be it in bulletproof processes like Amazon does with Prime Now. So just to get an understanding of where the industry is at, and archiving that knowledge for future reference if that comes up in my professional work, because I do some consulting with companies for supply chain as well. I think I've just covered 10% of what you have right here. So it's an immense gathering, an immense exhibit of different service providers. For me personally, I'm trying to look at AI and robotic process automation and machine learning. And just to see, like, we have been hearing that, and there's something that we call a hype cycle. Like, you hear about it and then it just kind of vanishes, like whatever happened to 3D printers and blockchain. What I'm trying to get out of this session here is it at what position in the hype cycle is AI, ML, and RPA right now, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and robotic process automation? Are there use cases? Do we have people who have been there, done that, who have been burnt, and they're ready to share the lessons with us, and how we can take that information and make it better for the second mover, because there's something called a second mover advantage as well, which is like learning out of the mistakes of the first movers. So my networking starts with introducing myself at the service providers, the exhibit stalls that we are having. That's the starting point for me. I already have seen quite a few folks that I've worked with in the past, so it's a good chance for me to reconnect with them and maybe get a coffee with them after. For folks with similar interests, if they're gathering for a seminar or a symposium or a talk, it would be nice to exchange business cards and get connected on LinkedIn. That's how I go about it. I'm always thrilled to be a part of the cargo logistics symposium, if I can call that. And I would like to extend my thanks to cargo logistics team for inviting me over today. And yeah, do expect me in the future for sure.